Dear brothers and sisters, today we are in the fourth week of Eastertide, Monday, 4th May. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, the Bible often speaks of God as good shepherd of his people Israel. In Psalm 23, the psalmist says, "The Lord is my shepherd." In Psalm 100 verse 3 say, "We are the people of his flock." Jesus says, "I am the good shepherd." Let us believe in him, have trust and confidence in his saying, because he preached what he practiced. As the sheep follows the shepherd, so too the countless sheep in this world have to follow the good shepherd to have the fullness of life. During this Holy Eucharistic celebration, let us plead the Eucharistic Lord to give us the strength, peace, security, and nourish us through his word and bread, so that the whole world can win over the battle of deadly pandemic disease of COVID-19. Let us have the genuine hope and faith that the Good Shepherd will never abandon us, but he will lead us and guide us always to the green pasture. To prepare this Holy Mass in a worthy manner, let us recall to our mind, especially the voice I did not hear, the Good Shepherd, the footprints which I did not follow, for all these sins, ask God's pardon and mercy. I confess to Almighty God and to my brothers and sisters that I have sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us and forgive us our sins and bring us to life everlasting. Amen. Let us pray. O God, perfect light of the blessed, by whose gift we celebrate the Paschal mysteries on earth, bring us, we pray, to rejoice in the full measure of your grace for ages unending. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. To the Gentiles also God has granted repentance unto life. The apostles and the brethren who were in Judah heard that the Gentiles also had received the word of God. So when Peter went up to Jerusalem, the circumcision party criticized him, saying, "Why did you go to uncircumcised men and eat with them?" But Peter began and explained to them in order, I was in the city of Joppa praying, but in trance I saw a vision, something descending like a great sheet, let down from heaven by four corners, and it came down to me. Looking at it closely, I observed animals and beasts of prey and reptiles and the birds of the air. And I heard a voice saying to me, "Rise, Peter, kill and eat." And I heard a voice saying to me, but I said, "No, Lord, for nothing common or unclean has ever entered my mouth." But the voice answered a second time from heaven, "What God has cleansed, you must not call common." This happened three times, and all was drawn upon again into heaven. At that very moment, three men arrived at the house in which we were, sent to me from Sisera, and the Spirit told me to go with them, making no distinction. Then six brethren also accompanied me, and we entered the man's house, and he told us how he had seen the angel standing in his house and saying, "Send to Joppa and bring Simon called Peter. He will declare to you a message by which you will be saved, you and all your household." As I began to speak, the Holy Spirit fell on them just as us at the beginning. And I remembered the word of Lord, how he said, "John baptized with water, but you shall be baptized with the Holy Spirit." If then God gave the same gift to them as he gave to us when we believed in Lord Jesus Christ, who was I that I could withstand God? When they heard this, they were silenced, and they glorified God, saying, "Then to the Gentiles also God has granted repentance upon him." This is the word of God.
Thanks be to God.
Samuel responds, "My soul is thirsting for Lord, the God of my life." Like the deer that yearns for running streams, so my life is yearning for you, my Lord. Your response?
My soul is thirsting for God, the God of my life.
When can I enter and see the face of God? Your response?
My soul is thirsting for God, the God of my life.
Oh, send forth your light and your truth. Let this be my guide. Let them bring me to your holy mountain, to the place where you dwell. Your response?
My soul is thirsting for God, the God of my life.
And I will come to the altar of God, the God of my joy. My Redeemer, I will thank you on the harp, O God, my God. Your response?
My soul is thirsting for God, the God of my life.
Acclamation. Jesus Christ, you are the faithful witness, the firstborn of the dead, and you love us and free us from our sins in your blood. Alleluia.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said, "Truly, truly, I say to you, he who does not enter the sheepfold by the door, but climbs in by another way, that man is a thief and a robber. But he who enters by the door is the shepherd of the sheep. To him the gatekeeper opens, the sheep hear his voice, and he calls his own sheep by name and leads them out. When he has brought out all his own, he goes before them, and the sheep follow him, for they know his voice. A stranger they will not follow, but they will flee from him, for they do not know the voice of strangers. This figure Jesus used with them, but they did not understand what he was saying to them. So Jesus again said to them, "Truly, truly, I say to you, I am the door of the sheep. All who came before me are thieves and robbers, but the sheep did not heed them. I am the door. If anyone enters by me, he will be saved and will go in hand and out and find pasture. The thief comes only to steal and kill and destroy. I came that they may have life and have it abundantly." This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Dear brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, in our day-to-day lives, we are proud enough to have good materials, good furnitures, good children, good parents, everything we want, everything goody-goody. Whether it is ornaments or electronic gadgets or dresses, etc., we are very happily expose them to our near and dear ones, what we have purchased, new things, the good things. But have we ever realized or proud enough to have Jesus Christ as my good shepherd in my life? Do I trust in him? Have I ever tried to give my good shepherd or proclaim him to my brethren? Am I ready to listen to him and obey him? Now let us contemplate on it. Jesus says in today's passage, "I am the good shepherd." It is obvious that during the time of Jesus, there were many false prophets, hired men who works for their only belly. That is why Jesus says, "I am the good shepherd." This can be seen in Matthew Gospel, chapter 23, verse 4. "For they do not practice what they teach." In today's whole passage tells about the intimate, personal, and mutual relationship between God and his Son, Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ wants to reveal that relationship to the human beings. As he is related to the Father, he is expecting that same relationship with us as his flock. In the New Testament, we see a lot of evidences that Jesus Christ, Messiah, is the Good Shepherd. The Good Shepherd is the one who lays down his life for the sake of his flock. He nurses them, and also he underwent the agony of Christ to break the power of Satan over man. A real and good shepherd fights with the wolves, savage beasts, and robbers in order to protect his flock. He sincerely acts with responsibilities. Whereas the real false prophet, on the other hand, abandons the sheep, neglects the sheep. As soon as he sees the wolf coming and attacking the flock, he easily escapes for his own life. He never takes up any risk or any responsibilities to safeguard the sheepfold. He works only for making money and for his own belly. When Jesus said, "I am the good shepherd," this statement might have made upset the Jewish leaders. They did not believe in him. Rather, they chided or criticized him as an insane. But in reality, Jesus is the good shepherd who is taking care of each human being in this world's biggest lockdown situation. Only thing we have to understand, God's plan and His purpose. We should know that God can write straight even on the curved lines. We can say that Jesus is the good shepherd because He not only nourishes us only the spiritual needs but also the moral needs. How to live in the family, how to live in the society, how to cooperate with each other, how to live for one another. That is the beauty of the good shepherd. He is the good shepherd because Jesus fulfills the covenant. What is that covenant? I am your God and you are my people. We know all of us are sinners. Though we are sinners, He says, you are my children. And also He promises the everlasting life. He who believes in Him and is baptized is saved. Mark 16 chapter 16th verse. When He saw a crowd, He had compassion on them because they were like a sheep without shepherd. So those people who came to listen to His message, He fulfills the needs of those 5,000 people by feeding them with bread. That is the good shepherd's nature. And also He respects the freedom of human beings. In Luke chapter 23 verse 34, at the cross, He prays for His enemies. Forgive them, they do not know what they are doing. If He is a normal person, or if He is a bad person, can He pray for these enemies? Certainly not. These things shows that Jesus Christ is our guardian of sinful souls. In Luke 15 chapter 4:7, we see in the parable of the lost sheep, He left the 99, but He went in search of the only one. That one sheep may be, that is myself. So He searches till He gets it back and He protects us in the flock. Yes, dear brother.
To get an extraordinary product, what?
Good raw materials. Jesus had these raw materials where? In His thoughts, in His mind and in His heart. But same thing, we too should cleanse our mind, our thoughts and our hearts by listening to Him. The raw material Jesus gives us, the Word of God. In our day-to-day life, by reading, meditating and practicing, pondering over it again and again, we can give witness to the Good Shepherd. By listening to His voice and walking in His light, we can evangelize to the world that Jesus Christ is Good Shepherd. During this Holy Eucharistic celebration, let us think that we see a lot of evidences that Jesus Christ is the true Messiah and He is the Good Shepherd. The Good Shepherd is the one who lays down His life. He underwent the agony of cross to break the power of Satan over man. So during this Holy Eucharistic celebration, let us earnestly pray to the Heavenly Father to make me a good sheep so that I can always follow the footprints of my Good Shepherd. And let me never listen and follow the false prophet or unfaithful shepherd. Help me, O Lord, to recognize Jesus as Good Shepherd in my parents, teachers, religious leaders, doctors, political leaders, nurses, etc., even those who hurt us. Amen.
In bread we bring you, Lord, our bodies labor. In wine we offer you our spirits.
For your goodness we have received this bread, we offer you fruit of your work of
mercy. We do not ask you, Lord, who is my neighbor, but stand united now, one in belief. Oh, we have gladly heard
your word,
your holy
brethren, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and the glory of His name, for our good and good of all His holy Church.
Receive, O Lord, we pray, these offerings of your exultant Church, and as you have given our cause for such great gladness, grant also that the gifts we bring may bear fruit in perpetual happiness, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord. But in this time, above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. He never ceases to offer himself for us, but defends us and ever pleads our cause before you. He is the sacrificial victim who dies no more, the lamb once slain who lives forever. Therefore, welcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and
indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At that time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and K. William our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by the divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those trespass against us. And lead us not into temptations, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take our sins. Show us mercy, Lord. Lamb of God, you take our sins. Show us mercy, Lord. Show us mercy. Show us mercy. Lamb of God, you take us. grant us all your peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold Him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Prayer for Spiritual Communion. Lord, as the centurion prayed, Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. We too, with total surrender, pray to you, Lord Jesus. Though we are unworthy to receive you into our hearts, without considering our limitations, Lord, by your love and blessings, help us to remain faithful to you. Grant us the grace to live as your children, bearing witness to your gospel every day. Help us to live a life according to the will of God, the Father. Come and help us to do your good works. Free us from all danger and protect us from every mishappenings. Fill us with your love and faith. Amen.
Jesus so stood in the midst of his disciples and said to them, Peace be with you. Alleluia. Let us pray. Look with us kindness upon your people, O Lord, and grant, we pray, that those you were pleased to renew by eternal mysteries may attain in their flesh the incorruptible glory of the resurrection. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace. Mass is ended. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia.
Alleluia. Alleluia.